Hello and welcome to NewsClick. I'm Sumedha, and today we're bringing you a glimpse of some of the most important stories that we report about at NewsClick. A two-day nationwide strike that has been called by 10 trade unions across the country kicked off in the wee hours of Tuesday morning. More than 20 crore workers from across the country are taking part in this general strike against the anti-people, anti-labour and more importantly, anti-national policies of the BJP government. The reports that are coming in are suggesting that the strike has been fairly successful in almost every state of India. Take a look.
Saibabad Radiant Polymers mein kaam karte hain. और हमें करीब 25 साल हो गए यहाँ काम करते हुए 97 से कर रहे हैं और अभी तक हमारी तनख्वाह जो है 12,000 रुपए है। अब 12,000 रुपए में पांच आदमियों का परिवार पालना तो मुश्किल हो जाता है। इससे बहुत मुश्किल से गुजारा करना पड़ता है। कभी कोई बीमार पड़ गया तो उसके लिए इलाज के लिए भी पैसे नहीं हो पाते हैं।
Unions from across spectrums such as banking, insurance, telecom, education, health and more importantly industrial workers are expected to take part in this two-day strike. But what are the demands of these workers? The workers across these spectrums are demanding minimum wages to be given to them. More importantly for industrial workers who are demanding an increment of the minimum wage to about 18,000 per month. While the contractual workers are demanding permanency of positions, women workers, even in 2019, have to struggle and fight a battle for equal wages. It seems that the Rafale controversy is not leaving the BJP anytime soon. According to the current chairman of HAL, R. Madhavan, the company is awaiting long overdue payments by the Indian Air Force. The payments can actually range up to rupees 20,000 crore by the end of this financial year. The Indian Air Force owes HAL the money for aircrafts, helicopters and other services that the company provided. The current dues by the Indian Air Force amount up to rupees 15,700 crore. But this amount can actually see a rise by the end of the year to about 20,000 crore rupees. Now what's interesting to note here is that while the Indian Air Force is delaying payments to HAL, it has been paying foreign vendors on time. Talking about controversies, the BJP government is humiliated yet again by the Indian Supreme Court. The court ordered that the exiled CBI chief, Alok Verma, to be reinstated to his office. The BJP government had divested him of his powers and sent him on a forced leave in a midnight swoop 3 months ago. While Alok Verma can go back to his office, he cannot take any major policy decisions for now. In the election season, the Supreme Court's ruling is being seen as a major setback for the BJP government, as well as a huge embarrassment. Opposition and other critics have repeatedly pointed out that the CBI is being used by the BJP to manipulate its rivals. There's good news which is coming in from our neighbouring country, Pakistan. A recent hearing, which was held by the National Commission for Human Rights, has paved a way to resolve a long-standing farmer struggle. The hearing, which took place on December 31st, related to the issue of the Okara military farms, whose farmers had waged a long struggle so that they were not evicted from their own land. During the hearing, the army actually admitted that they did not own the land and that the land belonged to the farmers. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. Stay tuned and for more updates, log on to our website www.newsclick.in. Also follow us on Facebook as well as subscribe to our channel on YouTube.